welcome again on the program. Good morning from Benin, the Richard from Independent Television. It doesn't matter the ground before that they look for how many weeks now, and the same people that have before they break up, because they don't become lecturers for this matter. I mean, they let us know how the thing they be. Even one of my brother when we say yes, he's there now. He has to come, even whether I get a head challenges or not. He say no, he must come. He come put this record straight. Make we know how it be. You know the matter of the talk now. The katakata when we say there for us for assembly for those states, and they think they born many many picking every day. All the children when we say with the born. We'll come to look at. Get two people here, barrister. Martha, that's it. Welcome to our program.
Thank you, sir.
Barrister.
Thank you, sir. Good morning to our people for house.
Okay. Yes. Abraham of Yahweh, the one person will be saying, you know how to draw your own rope. I know say go to draw a rope today.
Good morning, thank you very much.
I greet you.
My welcome.
Before we go last week, we did talk and I say, the way things they work, how they go. At the end of the day, the National Assembly, if they come take over, waiting they happen for the House of Assembly. And before I know what they happen, the House of Reps people come, they go back, they say they give Mr. Governor 1 week, make it write another proclamation letter, make you advertise her, make you do proper inauguration, make you do another inauguration. And I know call it proper inauguration, but make you do another inauguration, make all the 24 members of the House, maybe say they come. Say if they don't do one, within that 7 days, they will come, they will take over the proceedings of the House. And our brother, yeah, we talk on that and say, the way they go, say the law give them the power to do them. Our brother here, and what I say, say no be like that. Are we saying that the people now, the rights of rape member, when we say they consider the acts outside the law? Make I ask you, my brother, Emata.
Yeah, thank you, my brother, and our people for house now. Good morning. Mm. You know, it is very unfortunate, say, House of Reps alone take that decision.
Okay.
Because our constitution here, we don't read here that day. Mm. That last Friday, we come talk, say, now the National Assembly get that power. Mm. It is a joint responsibility. Senate.
No, you say that joint responsibility, I say that national
of the National Assembly. That's what joint. Section 11 says.
Okay.
Me and my brother, we agree on that in our National Assembly, get that power.
Mm.
And funny enough, Senate, the committee they set up, they Benin, as we hear for Abuja, say don't pass that resolution. Direct police, DSS, may they shut down the assembly. Direct the governor, may issue fresh proclamation within 1 week. Tell them how you go to issue the proclamation against the provisions of Section 105 of the Constitution. They not just end there and come now. They not just end there. They say all the decisions here, the 7th Assembly take, they declare them null and void and unconstitutional. It's sad because it is only a military decree that could have achieved that.
Okay.
Remember I say when military come, they'll come with decree number 1 of 1966.
Mm.
So everything suspend certain provisions of the Constitution, all the things here, all the things here former civilian government do, they go cancel everything. I can only describe that resolution as a legislative decree of an over-ambitious House of Representatives, because that power is not theirs, but a joint responsibility of the National Assembly. You know, I won that day. Say, if we not respect rule of law, now this kind of kata-kata will be the same.
Okay.
Because even Senate, I don't think Senate will support this kind of thing. I give you an example. When you want to amend the Constitution, the 1999 Constitution, not the only House of Reps if you amend them. It is a joint responsibility of both the House of Reps and Senate.
Okay.
But it's unfortunate that we find ourselves in this situation. And at the appropriate time, courts will comment on this thing because the matter is still the courts. Thank you.
Okay, Bill, I say for this one, you hear what he said. You say, if they talk and now, say, within the House of Reps, do that committee, they say it's null and void and it was anchored. You can use now language at time, and they anchor and rest my case on this. They won't be saying it's no day for inside the law.
No, my brother, I only partially agree with her. See, to the extent that the National Assembly now get the power under Section 11.4 of the 1999 Constitution. But my brother could also appreciate the fact, say, if any bill or any of such constitutional assignment come National Assembly like that, you know, they only go only reps. Or you know they go only Senate. Now both houses they go. And when the thing pass through both houses go get their version of decision for that same issue. For example, they will get their own version of decision for that same issue. With the SIAM, when they say they want to pass a bill into law, it will go through both houses. After both houses don't take and through their various reading, they will come get joint session of the National Assembly. Reps go come, Senate go come. Then they will come present the both version when both of them get. They go harmonize them. They go harmonize them. So waiting, when I hear people, they talk, say, Rep, I never they address the specific decisions when they take. Not being I don't they address now. I the only address say what the step the national the House of Reps don't currently take is very much in order in terms of passing of resolution. But again, by mere passing of that resolution, it never give effect to Section 11.4 because House of Rep na one half of the National Assembly. The other half still they work. So when they also finish, they go come meet. Senate don't tell you, a rep don't tell you, say, now our version of what we see be this one. When you come with your version, we look at, if you dare to together, it's easy to roll. If you don't dare together, we go harmonize them. There must be a point where we not be harmonized. Then if reps not going to be harmonized, you come, if Senate and rep not going to be harmonized, that will be the bigger proper problem. The problem will come worse past the one when member elect and said inaugurated purposes they get for those states. House of Assembly. The point I'm trying to make, my brother, is that without prejudice to the decisions when they take for that their resolution, the Senate or the House of Representatives have powers to pass that resolution. Mere passage of that resolution not automatically give effect to them because the law said the National Assembly. Now, when reps and when Senate don't also come with their own version of what they don't pass, they will get joint session, joint committee session also. Possibly they go harmonize them, or they will just choose to get joint National Assembly session. They go harmonize before the issue, and by that time, maybe not be the way reps even to put them now. Your country come out. There may be modifications. Now all this one I talked the other day, the last time we come here,
last Friday.
Yes, make all these people know because. When you wake up in the night, inaugurate a house, or they say people wake up in the night, because the night you go ask me now, I did inside. When you strike the first blow of illegality, you open the floodgate for every other thing to come. Now, but I talked that day. I said, we all they clap now, say, nine people get power to form a House of Assembly, whereas Section 91 of this Constitution says that no House of Assembly in this country shall exceed 40 members and shall be less than 24 members. Currently, today, as constituted, can the clerk of the Edo State House of Assembly beat his chest to say that for the purpose of inauguration, he invited 24 persons, thereby giving effect, having been so elected, to Section 91 of the Constitution? What is on an issue when we go continue to the ruminate, we go the reason now, we go the talk and we go the talk and until the judiciary go constantly paid for the matter, or constantly mabaka. And at the end of the day, because so many talk don't full town, so say matter when they caught, now reps call the poo mat. And me also ask those people when they talk and I say, hey, so you should say the matter they caught, now the speaker. Matter they court. Now those persons when the party to the case for court go sit down for panel with the same member of the House of Reps for matter when you say they court. Now you they go discuss with the watch our television. You yourself never create problem for yourself. You say matter they court. You go sit down with the same committee. They narrate what you they narrate for court. What you don't say the day court. You they narrate to the entire public. That kind of matter. Who now come? Who they disobey the court now? You when can I go court? Or you when they tell us say the matter?
Okay, no problem. We will come back to you because as you see, you raise your hand because now class will not be see the you raise your hand up like one of the students they were BCS they teach for this day because now it's supposed to be in a classroom setting and I say the only do. So I want to find out why they raise your hand up just now.
Do I not raise my hand?
But you.
I just
that part for television. Yeah. But what you do?
I call your attention to one fact. See, we don't agree on certain things here, namely that the National Assembly get that power. It make reference to the fact.
No, I partially agree with you.
Yeah, he partially agree with me, but I just want to put the record straight. When you talk of resolution, at the level of the National Assembly, there's a word we use for it, legislation. It begins with a bill, right? If you want to pass law. Then when that bill don't go through the process, it becomes an act of the National Assembly.
Okay.
The similar version of bill, now motion.
Okay.
Once you don't discuss, debate, motion, you pass that motion, it becomes a resolution. But this idea of you can't publish waiting over go senior, because what the drafters of this document contemplated was a situation where, like in the case of the Constitution, there's always a joint committee headed by the Deputy Senate President as chairman. That will never happen here. Because the idea is that the Constitution does not empower just one organ to act unilaterally.
Okay.
Already the House of Reps has a resolution which has been published. The police is on red alert. The DSS is on red alert. Not as they may be waiting for the Senate, but at the end of the day, what will the Senate now do? Because already they have foisted a fait accompli on the Senate. But I know the Senate may not totally agree with them. But the problem remains.
No, you think the Senate...
It's an opinion. Uh-huh. But the problem remains. This issue is before a court of competent jurisdiction. Let me give an information. My brother here may not be aware that.
This same, grammar comes
yes, out. My brother here, if you don't know, say, this same House of Assembly members, yeah, they elect, members elect, yeah, they Abuja, on the 25th of June, the Rongo Court asked for ex parte order to restrain the speaker. That matter is currently before High Court No. 5, Justice Irabo.
Okay.
Just yesterday, the application for ex parte order, court refusal.
Okay.
On the eve of when that motion go National Assembly, they were in court to move their motion. They argued their motion. They think, say, the court will just grant ex parte order. Of course, the court not grant, and they adjourned the matter to 18th of July, which was yesterday. And because court not grant that order, they don't go Abuja. Already, they don't plan, say, plan A. If court don't grant our order, we will go to plan B. Plan B was the following day, which was 9th of July. A member of their faction, Professor Julius Ihome, removed that motion on the floor of the house. We tried informing the court that they were in court the previous day to get an ex parte order so that they can take over the house. So when my brother, they talk of quorum, and I laugh. Or rather, they talk of membership of the House of Assembly. I just want to clarify one house, point. Bro. Section 96 is very clear as to quorum. It's very explicit that for the House of Assembly to meet as a House of Assembly of the States, you need 1/3 of the entire membership. As a lawyer, I had 80 in mathematics. 1/3 of 24 is 8, and you had 9 members.
Don't pass 1/3 already.
Of course. So with that 9 members, the meetings of the House will continue to hold indefinitely and continuously. The membership of the House, excuse me, sir, with profound respect, let me complete this point. The membership of the House, as contemplated by the 1999 Constitution, is not without reference to the fact that not all the 24 members were there at the same time. Remember, say, when Saraki becomes Senate President, not all of them were there. Yeah. There were some members at the National Conference Center, International Conference Center. But at the end of the day, the members there formed the quorum, and that National Assembly had its complete term. Before that time, the House of Reps, there was a time about how many of them die. Senate, how many of them die? You cannot have 24 members at the same time. It is not possible. But once you can form a quorum, by the grace of God, I teach constitutional law. And in the law of meetings, once you can form a quorum, that House can sit without any problem. And again, the drafters of our constitution also contemplated a situation where not be all of them go there at the same time. That is why there is provision for vacancy. Section 107 says, if for the periods House go sit, you not sit for 1/3 of the period, which is 181 days, they will declare your seat vacant. People make a constitution, imagine this kind of situation. Say there are some people that may want to go and be watching proceedings of the House of Reps in Abuja. thereby abdicating their duties as lawmakers in Edo. You declare their seats vacant. Okay. And if after 2 months, which is 60 days, they not come, speaker get power to declare their seats vacant. Okay. And they will not have to go to court over that one.
We go come to that one. But one of that thing when they say the team they get the way they been, and I mean the team when they say even the House of Red stock, the members when they say come, they say they give Mr. Governor 1 week to write another proclamation letter, make it come everybody, then they come swear them in. I want to ask you that way. Constitution allow that kind of a thing. They write a proclamation letter 2 times.
Let me quickly, before I respond to that clear, and I'll be very straight about it, say that the reference to section 96. I just also quickly state my proposition clearly in a word or two. I've done random up.
Okay.
Section 96 that talks about issue of quorum. My brother must appreciate the fact, say, the issue of quorum for sitting will come up after inauguration. Not before their house, when you still be member.
But
we get a situation of, he talk about Saraki case now.
Of course.
Saraki, some members there for inside the house. They swear themselves in, and Saraki become this.
Because they had a quarrel. They had a quarrel.
Very good.
I want to marry that one.
That Saraki matter, who issued the proclamation? Did that proclamation, did it specify the date, the time, and the venue of that inauguration?
I don't know if you remember.
That one, they part of the issue.
But you know, but tell you, say, governor won't get those same details.
My brother, are they come now? Are they come? The point I'm trying to make, when he makes Saraki, and I may not have clear details, but my argument is that if you don't issue proclamation letter, and then say, by next tomorrow, they're going to inaugurate all of them by 3 p.m., and you elect not to be there, it's a different issue entirely. When the letter, when you save that proclamation, no venue, no time, and the date for the inauguration not also day. The date for the inauguration itself not also day.
You get a copy of the proclamation?
It's there everywhere for internet now. They hide. You know, hide.
Okay.
The point I'm trying to make, that brings me to the question when you ask me. There is no provisions in our law, in section 105 or so, section 3, that directs or that creates a situation of reissuance of proclamation letter. There is no such provisions in our law. Laws are meant for men, not men for laws. If I issue a letter of proclamation and arising from either meeting of the minds, we now agree that for peaceful coexistence, there is need for me to reissue it. The law does not forbid me from doing it. But if I insist on my right as governor, like the governor is doing, that I have issued the letter of proclamation. What happens thereafter is that
the
governor can insist on his right. Yes, he says it. Yes, he says it.
So by application,
if he doesn't want to,
it's not binding on the governor to write it again.
No, there is no. They cannot compel him.
Okay.
If the government says, I'm not reissuing it, I have exercised my power under section 105, whether I exercise it rightly or wrongly is for the courts to determine. But as an individual, the government says, I don't exercise my power. And I agree with him that he has exercised his power, whether rightly or wrongly. It's another different kettle of fish entirely. But to say he has not exercised it, that one, I cannot come here to say he should go and reissue it. They can sit on the table of their various political parties and agree that as a way of a peaceful coexistence, you go drive, you go issue this thing again. Okay, now you don't issue one before. Okay, now you don't go write it. Tell the clerk make it bring.
You don't go there against the law.
I
just see some lawyer they talk and say, if the governor
writes
another letter, proclamation letter, see the governor sworn.
Now governor issue proclamation letter. The governor has said it from the beginning that I don't issue one to the clerk. Whatever happened thereafter is that of that. Yes, it's the business of the clerk. Legally speaking, the governor is very correct, and I agree with him. I agree with him on that point. And when the governor continued to toe that line consciously, knowing fully well the circumstances that gave birth to the inauguration of the nine persons. Mm. It means that he wants to hold his hard line strong. Mm. It means that the problem go long. Mm. It means that it go long. But I will continue to advocate, my brother. I have soft side for the governor because of some level of development he have put in place. But unfortunately, in this regard, very unfortunately, and painful to me because of the soft side I have for the governor in recent time, bringing some level of hygiene in politics,
okay,
as it were. I tell you, with all sense of responsibility, that I disagree radically with his perspective with respect to the issue of the Edo State House of Assembly. As we speak now, I disagree radically with him. But on other issues, I agree with him. Mm-hmm. And let me reiterate.
Mm-hmm. All the grammar, all the plates.
That when thing with the accused of Obaseki saying,
Governor
Obaseki, now with debate of respect to him as governor of Edo State. Now, brother, the one who Oshomole do as governor, when we cry for this, they play worse, papa's the one when we talk so. Mm-hmm. So anything you see say they happen, fire they burn. Mm-hmm. Now, what is so now the ripple? Yesterday they call him name, Naibi this one, Naibi that one. Today, when I wake up this morning, I don't know when I today say evil at death, I will continue to address Chief Anthony Anene as Saint Anthony Anene. Saint, he's a saint.
Okay. Why you call her saint that?
Yes, because people don't declare say Oshomole na Godfather. Now Godfather. His reign of Godfather is in Anene have reached 2 years. He doesn't receive injury. What? And then he was there for several years. And even at that, he was able to resolve. There was never a time, I tell you, when you have a political party that do not have internal democracy, and they show you the issues of internal democracy, these are challenges you will find. It has never happened in Edo State that you have 24 over 24 in one political party in the House of Assembly.
Okay.
Today we have it. Is it a blessing or a curse?
And because the way they work now, we don't call it a blessing.
And of course, I ask, is it a blessing or a curse?
Okay, we come to.
Is that not, that matter not supposed to support the governor to drive in the development the way they drive?
Okay, no worry, we will come to that. But it's a matter.
Yes.
Look, we look this matter when they say it concerns the threats by the National Assembly. When we say House of Reps don't already come. Yes. It gets some kind of where we say people they talk before they come. And yes. No one believes in that. So
okay.
Maybe what we would their side now with the way they talk say blessed people know the end even from the beginning. You understand? There's no way we say they go even before they leave Abuja and come Edo State. And my brother talking last week said the people of the National Assembly are men of integrity and all of that.
Me?
You say once they come, they are no longer members of a political party.
Exactly.
I remember now. They are members of a political party.
I'll say that they be men of integrity.
But they do their own work now. I say that they do it for. They do it for the interest of the generality of this, not for the political party.
That's what we perceive.
So, what do we call the here now for some people? What we say we put that side now? Because another person maker, I will bring the matter call here now. We say, when I talk to you, people already know their end, even from the beginning. What did that one mean?
I will tell you the truth. You know, when we talk of this matter today, we must look at the past, because without the past, we cannot determine the present. And the future. In the Western region, this same thing play out, where at that time, the Sadona was controlling the national parliament, as a parliament at the center. Because of the interest they say they get against Awolowo, they come to create certain crises using Ladoke Akintola.
Okay.
And coming from that same angle, historically, you will discover that this present National Assembly under the leadership of both the Senate President, who is an APC member, and the Speaker, Femi Gbajabiamila, who is loyal to the man in Lagos. Mm-hmm. Because you know the man in Lagos and the man in Edo, they have a conspiracy as godfathers.
Only the men when you talk about, so.
Yeah, so coming back.
I don't know to the man in Lagos, because I don't say many men.
Of course. And I know the man.
Okay.
We know the line of the man they call Lion of Bodilon, right? I don't want to mention the name, but we know the man, Tinubu, right? We know Adams Oshomole, our national chairman. because this was the same person that spoke against God's fatherism in this state. Oh, no man is God. Of course, that was Grace Group mantra. Then the man come talk, say, we must retire the Godfathers. We must, we not know, say, as he want to retire, now you want to assume that office. Because the man wants to determine who is speaker and who is sweeper, who is governor and who is gardener, who is even the president of the customary court of appeal. And when that didn't work some years ago, this man single-handedly ensured that that court was scrapped. Because he wanted a particular person to be president of the customary court. I mean, customary president court. Of court of appeal.
Okay.
As provided for. In the, yeah, customary court of appeal. On the same pedestal with the high court. Oshomole spearheaded the move because his own preferred candidate was not within the seniority cadre. Made that court to become different. But I hear recently said the governor won't bring back that court. So I'm trying to say that Godfatherism is the biggest problem of our politics. So if you hear, say, House of Reps, even before the committee come, they don't give them scripts. Then they go work.
No, they talk for us.
No, it's true because the plenary they take come with yes and that person. This same.
But I don't know. Yes.
No, excuse me. House of Reps. Excuse me. No, not matter of issues. To rent a chartered aircraft, not be. We're not talk of multi million. Where House of Reps go get that kind of money? To send people on assignments. You put them for chartered aircraft. It was paid for, certainly. And at the same interest. Not pay for that aircraft. But unfortunately for us, at the end of the day, look at the disaster that came out from that assignment. I call it a disaster because the House of Reps now assume judicial powers. First of all, governor of a state, you issue him 7 days. The governor is not a local government LCDA chairman that you would just give that kind of. And the man within Section 105 had issued a proclamation. The proclamation is what you call.
They bring the grammar conduct.
No, the proclamation are waiting. Constitution say do once, and once you do them, your rule don't finish.
No, is it for constitution and once they go do them?
Of course.
No, because what are they read? What are they read for me? I say, Isha, do this. You don't talk the number of times.
Once that proclamation is issued, it's like when money happened, you don't feel reverse money.
Okay. We got somebody for line because don't open the line, people don't call it. We got somebody for line. Hello, yes. Good morning. Hello, good morning.
Hello, good morning.
Who would they talk with you?
Osawa gave me my name.
You go always call talk on it. Hey, Osawa gave me your name.
So I think I can listen to now and interest in the same percent of people.
No, because the matter don't graph for things for long. We never finish it.
Okay, I beg. The constitutional lecturer there. I want please permit me. The people where they never take the oath of office. Now, what did them be? Are they members of the House of Assembly or members elect?
You have to talk.
I get the question.
Answer the question now. Easy, they wait.
Okay.
Are they members of the House of Assembly or members elect?
Of course, they are members elect.
Okay, leave it there. You see, they are members elect.
If they are members elect, by your status as a lecturer, that section 96 that you
excuse
mentioned,
me, don't go into my status as a lecturer. I'm speaking as a lawyer. Don't just leave it to a lecturer.
Hello? Make a read out for you, make you hear. Say the quorum of the House of Assembly shall be one third of all the members of the House, not members elect. So that's your interpretation of quorum to be 9, my brother, is not founded in the Constitution. Because the Constitution talk about members of the House of Elect, members of the House of Assembly, not members elect. So before you talk about quorum, you must get members first. And the members, now when you get there, will be 9. The quorum are 3. So you cannot be calculating members elect to not calculate what a quorum is. Then right. I want also draw your attention. Hello?
Are they
hello?
Carry on.
I want also draw your attention. So what is the meaning of proclamation? I want to read that to your hearing. As a constitutional lecturer, Black Law Dictionary, 8th edition. Make a read that make you hear. It says, a formal public announcement made by the government. A formal public announcement. That is what it means. So when you lecture on in the university, make they take time, they make.
I'll quickly respond to the issues he has raised.
Okay,
because I noticed that he's a regular caller. It means that he's always on this radio and TV for this purpose. And I said it before that he has always spoken as one with an interest. And of course, I don't need to go into that any further. He mentioned 2 things, and I'll take them one after the other. But for the issue of confirmation, I don't know what he was trying to drive at with confirmation. Maybe my colleague here will. Proclamation. Of course, proclamation would not even need any further explanation. You make a statement, either in writing, but in this case, the Constitution makes it mandatory for it to be in writing with all those details. And I don't want us to overstress the issue or overflog the issue of proclamation. But I might quickly take the issue of member elect. Of course, apart from the fact that they teach constitutional law, they teach other courses. When you talk of law of meetings, at the point of inauguration, it is a plenary sitting of the House, right? At that point, you are a member elect, right? It is for the purpose of oath taking. And for that purpose, the provision on quorum applies because it's a meeting of the House. Is it not a meeting of the House? It is a meeting of the House. Maybe, the inaugural meeting of the House.
Okay.
Because even if there's a lacuna, you still have to depend on the quorum stipulated because the law of meetings, there must be a quorum.
Because they see sometimes, say, maybe.
So for them to not argue, say, because those ones say they also be members elect, the Constitution contemplates an inaugural meeting. And for the purposes of that inaugural meeting, the constitutional requirement of quorum must be met.
Okay, before Obiago go respond to that one, because I don't know why Obiago they argue most times with my brother. Now they teach on a law now, you know this one? I don't know how it is, according to that. So how it comes like,
we don't know it all.
Okay.
It's like what Lorden said. God forbid that I'll know all the law.
Okay.
We they learn every day.
Okay.
And nobody will fit claim monopoly
on money. I salute you for what my friend Goto say. I salute you for your humility.
Like we did talk for this matter now, very simple. For me, I say, make we not bend this thing. Make we not bend this thing.
Make the cost they come, you know.
It's like students, whenever I do matriculation, my students, you they call them, who never matriculate. Na students. Now upon inauguration, now you become member. And those of una when be members, now from there una go to talk of quorum. If you want to calculate quorum, you're not going to use member elect. There is the law not provide for quorum for member elect.
I'm surprised.
Now upon inauguration, now the issue because section 96 made reference to member. And for you to be a member, you must have taking your oath of office and oath of allegiance. And after you don't take this one, now you don't become member of the House. The issue of quorum, now then you will begin to talk. When they never inaugurate you for House, you want to say you're an honorable member. After that inauguration, now you can say you're not even an honorable member. So my brother, when you say now nine people, they there, na quorum. Nobody argue with you, say nine don't fall within the one-third quorum of 24. But the argument now say, as at the time you they calculate nine as quorum, the member elect for the House.
Okay, we'll get somebody for online. Hello, good morning.
Good morning, this is Osatu for Ubo.
Osatu, where are you there for call from?
Ubo. I call from Ubo, Benin City.
Okay, what do you want me to know? In this case, that is supposed to do. They say the House of X. Say because, like we talked yesterday, they say we don't know the ending from the beginning. If they talk and say people don't know the F from the beginning, if you're supposed to tell those people the way they say they did there. When come on, we go Abuja now, the other people. So may they come back, may they come, may they inaugurate them. So why should the man write another letter of proclamation? Why didn't he? Because you talk, say, yes, if the man decide to hold on to that one, say, no, go to that one, say, you support her.
He said, why didn't he? I say, he's on his right.
You say, they stand on the side of legal matter. I mean, let me
say, and he's entitled to stand on his right.
So they said that they expect the National Assembly to have asked those people, make them come, make them inaugurate them. I want me to take her from there.
Yes, depends on the side you are looking at it from. Naturally, from my own point of view, I'm a realist. I like to hit issues the way they ordinarily be. When the foundation is wrong, you must find a way around that. My brother, make we tell ourselves the very bitter truth. All these 9 members, now who want to be in charge of, who want to be speaker, who want to be deputy speaker, now leadership of the house, now they cause all this entire problem. If the members elect, because politicians are very funny people, my brother. Me, I used to come here with the speak grammar here, but in the afternoon they'll do another one.
Okay, so what you do for that? Hello, good morning.
Hello, good morning. I speak to ITV.
Yes, who they talk with?
My name is Komido Sase Ugebe.
Sase, how you doing?
I call from my Wotubu.
Okay.
I want to talk one too, because this matter today has to be. Who is there those states? Who knows there those states? No get problem. We are everywhere, they're peaceful. When the country and the police won't take over, we don't know what it will be. So we know the state of West not get power. We do not have to say not get power to hold the cover, to copy the government, to the governor. Make police won't take over assembly. And if we want to become the government, my house of assembly member and this is the country everybody. Suppose they have now, they direct going to pick up the same government of saying, our way of no good. I want to book it as it is.
Because this is my brother, just the best, plenty. They say, because now I'm on the same team when we see
now
the
first guy. Now we hear the pain, that guy they tell you now, because now he represents Wednesday there, Abuja now. Now he's supposed to be address, yes, issues. See the problem when my own constituents get on how we go to resolve. Everybody talking to him. The summary of all this is that, why we need to be very careful is that, they need to resolve these issues as long as possible. Assuming they resolve these issues sometime January or February next year, for example, and they can say, okay, the one the governor issued initially, it not work, maybe they issue fresh one. Now, from that day, they issue one, they inaugurate, and they ask about same status.
Okay, but more, want to more, I just want to when we say this, my brother talk now. He say, no crisis. He say, they won't be saying different. They say, they don't get crisis. Even people who enter streets, they say, we don't get crisis, so why they won't take over the place? And all of that. Don't be people when we say get this thing. Don't be go talk whether we get crisis or we don't get crisis. I want to find out.
If you look at all this, you will discover that the most important category, the people of Edo State, that is the most important category. Because these honorable members, one will say representing Oredo East, or representing Oredo West, representing Ego, representing who there, it is the people they are representing. And it is because these people have this mentality of, oh, my godfather might take me there, so my godfather might be loyal to. These so-called honorable members elect in Abuja, they are taking Edo people for a ride. And that is why we've been having series of protests, series of rallies. And it's painful because really, Section 14 of our constitution talks says sovereignty belongs to the people of Nigeria, from whom government derives its power and authority. Now, within Section 14, sub 2 of our Constitution talk. And unfortunately,
the protection of
the course, the security and welfare of the people. That will get A and B,
okay.
Right?
Okay.
It starts with sovereignty, belongs to people of Nigeria, from whom government derives its authority and power. Then the other partner says the security and welfare of the people shall be the primary purpose of government and all of that. So, unfortunately for us, he mentioned the Igor person, Crosby. Now there, me the votes, Igor. Now there, me the stay. When he go 4 years, we'll never see the evidence of 4 years in Igor.
No,
we are talking of these people who are in Abuja. When they have responsibility, they were elected to represent their people in Edo State, in Benin City, at Anthony Enauro complex. So the idea of not going to Abuja, all because we suppose they're there first, and we're not there. We're down that place. All these things, at the end of the day, amount to one thing: lack of representation. And I'm happy somebody from Igor has added his voice on the need for these 12 members elect to come back. Because these same people have gone to court. They filed a matter on the 25th, mentioning the speaker, deputy speaker, if they believe, say, there was no inauguration. Not be caught for the side arm. And unfortunately, because that court not favored them, they can't go to National Assembly. I know this grammar you would speak, as my brother talk. Osawa get called from outside. He was now reading from the Black's Law Dictionary, reading from the Constitution. Is he a judge?
Okay, no problem.
Is he not the judiciary that should be allowed to do that work? Unfortunately, we are just jumping the gun.
They ran off now. This man, wait, the people, you know, after the one went up, the man say, we see rallies for town yesterday, people come out. And the man when he called for Igor now say, he say, people of Edo State say they don't get wahala and all of that. They say for democracy, the wish of the people.
Yeah.
What people
but I agree with you absolutely. Mm. But again, like I tell you, I'll be realist. I don't want to make with the talk say, Christ is not there, Christ is not there, Christ is not there. If people say, wait till they do us, we're not going to agree. 12 or 14 of them. Like my brother exposed to us now, say they go court before Honorable Justice Irabo. Some say they write petition to IG, write to National Assembly. My brother, in as much as you say they go Abuja, not be bad thing they do. You for prefer say may they recruit those people when follow they do election, may they go the fight to solve this problem.
Okay, you don't talk and I say problem for you now.
The point that they try to tell you now say, before National Assembly exercise that their powers, now all these issues that they put into consideration,
okay,
whether the issue is sufficient enough
or not
for them to arrive at the decision, if they so arrive at the decision, and the court now go measure them.
Okay, but wait now, wait first. We don't say and say the court, people are also wahala. The more courts they talk for the matter, the more the wahala they see they expand. They can't get the one we say they call alternative dispute resolution, whatever. You know, if you say another way supposed to be able to look to
I agree with you, my brother.
Because the way
the shortest way.
Mm-hmm.
You know, say any day I talk, I always the end the talk say maybe they go settle themselves. They are all from the same political party.
So by implication,
unfortunately, what if one of them when I talk to him, how can I deceive all of us? Who are the same? When they share money now, when I go begin smile for each other. Now we when they talk here, now be enemies. He tell me say now the party when they don't restrain, now want intervene for the matter. Now say okay, if they restrain National Working Committee, they also restrain the state party executive for state here. He said those ones don't compromise.
Okay.
But you see where the problem is. Because the ATR now, human being wants to talk put.
Okay, the ATR now, Alternative Resolution, whatever committee. You know, if you say that one, I go better pass. Because this one, like, they carry the law. The more they carry the law, the more they tie the more. You know, if you say, yes, we'll look for political solution to this matter rather than say, we'll go to the court or we'll go to court, we'll look for legal resolution to the matter.
You know, as a matter of fact, both sides don't go courts, right? National Assembly, the step they take, they won't make the matter day worse. I'll tell you why I say the matter day worse. Already, the Senate will still come up with their own. And that will create a new dimension. Because
if the court talk,
my brother, excuse me, if you go to church, go meet pastor, may pray for you, which in this case, I'll refer to the national, or rather, the courts. You know, if you meet pastor, go meet native doctor at the same time. Okay. Because already, these people were in court on the 25th, they filed the matter. The application was refused. They went to National Assembly. They go meet native doctor. Right?
Pastor, native doctor,
when the God will go for matter, you will not send my God to intervene.
Okay.
I will pray that God should grant the people who are involved the wisdom to allow the judiciary. And judiciary in this case is the last hope of the common man. So now they will play the role of God
in
this matter.
So, not talk
so they will give justice and nothing short of justice in
and
this
matter.
Very
matter. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Abraham. Obiang, we thank you well, because this is blessed thing they wish the ball. But I can't go to agree, say, yes, it could make we try some other.
No, it's the way. It's the way.
But if not, this one, the way.
Now, our development will suffer.
We don't make our development suffer. If not, now we are with it. Now we will see the name of the program, Good Morning from Benin.